Rabies is an ancient disease that still poses a deadly threat today. Although rabies is rare in developed countries, it remains a serious public health issue in parts of Africa and Asia, where access to vaccines and treatment is limited. According to the World Health Organization, rabies causes around 59,000 deaths each year, mostly in rural areas where dog vaccination programs are lacking. In this video, we'll dive deep into the pathophysiology, transmission, symptoms, diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of this deadly viral infection. Rabies is a viral infection caused by the rabies virus, a member of the Lyssavirus genus, which belongs to the Rhabdoviridae family. It is an RNA virus, typically affecting mammals, and is nearly 100% fatal once symptoms appear. Rabies primarily attacks the central nervous system, targeting both the brain and the spinal cord, leading to severe neurological symptoms and death if left untreated. The most common mode of transmission is through the bite or scratch of an infected animal. The virus is present in the saliva of infected animals and enters the body through skin breaks or mucous membranes. In over 99% of cases, rabies is transmitted by domestic dogs. However, other animals like bats, raccoons, foxes, and skunks can also be carriers. Bats, in particular, have become a leading cause of rabies transmission in the Americas. Once the rabies virus enters the body, it remains at the site of infection for a period before traveling via the peripheral nerves to the central nervous system. The virus uses the nervous system as a highway, moving rapidly toward the brain. Once it reaches the brain, it causes encephalitis or inflammation of the brain. From the brain, the virus spreads to other organs like the salivary glands, eyes, and skin. This spread leads to the classic symptoms of rabies, including hydrophobia, paralysis, and eventually death. The incubation period for rabies varies from 1 to 3 months, depending on factors like the location of the bite and the viral load. Early symptoms are often nonspecific and include fever, fatigue, and headache, similar to many viral illnesses. As the virus spreads to the brain, more severe symptoms appear. These are often grouped into two forms: furious rabies and paralytic rabies. In the more common form, furious rabies, patients experience hyperactivity, confusion, hallucinations, and aggressive behavior. A hallmark symptom is hydrophobia, or a fear of water caused by painful muscle spasms in the throat when swallowing. In the less common paralytic rabies, patients experience muscle weakness, beginning at the site of the bite and gradually spreading. Eventually, it leads to total paralysis. This form can take longer to develop, but is equally fatal. Diagnosing rabies can be challenging before symptoms appear. Once symptoms start, the disease is almost always fatal, so early detection is crucial. Lab tests are performed on saliva, skin biopsies, or cerebrospinal fluid to detect the virus. Post-mortem diagnosis in animals is typically done by examining the brain tissue for Negri bodies, which are inclusions found in neurons infected with rabies. Once rabies symptoms begin, there is no effective treatment. However, if treated immediately after exposure, rabies is preventable with post-exposure prophylaxis. This includes a series of rabies vaccinations and, in some cases, rabies immunoglobulin, which provides immediate passive immunity, PE. P must be given as soon as possible, ideally within the first 24 hours after exposure. Delayed treatment significantly reduces its effectiveness. Prevention is key when it comes to rabies. Routine vaccination of pets is one of the most effective strategies to control the spread of the virus. Public education on avoiding contact with wild or stray animals is equally important. In high-risk populations, like veterinarians and wildlife workers, pre-exposure rabies vaccination is recommended. For travelers, visiting regions where rabies is endemic, vaccination may also be advised.